Okay, in this video I just want to talk about doing some division where the numbers that you're dividing have decimals in them. So I've got a couple examples here. I'm going to do three examples. I'm going to take 2 and divide it by the number 0.25. I'm going to take 15.6 and divide it by 0.12, and I'm going to divide 0.286 by 0.4. And to me, the basic idea, the way I do these at least, is I get rid of the decimal in the denominator, so again, basically get rid of the decimal in the bottom of the fraction, and then I just do division. So what do I mean by that? Well, let's do a couple here. So let's take 2 and divide that by 0.25. So one thing to notice is the number on top, plain old 2, it doesn't have a decimal in there, but we can always write it with a decimal expansion. And I'm going to write it as 2.00. And the reason I choose that many zeros is, well, I notice on the bottom, to get rid of the decimal place, I would have to move the decimal 2 places to the right. Okay. Well, if you move the decimal place in the bottom 2 places to the right, to keep this an equivalent fraction, you also have to move the decimal place 2 places to the right in the numerator and the top of the fraction as well. And really, arithmetically, all we're doing is we're multiplying, so 2 places to the right, we're multiplying the top and bottom of the original fraction, really by the number 100 is what we're doing. Okay, so we're just multiplying top and bottom by 100. And that has the effect of moving the decimal place 2 places to the right in both top and bottom. Okay, so if I do that, I'm going to get the new number, 200 divided by 25, and now I simply do my division. Okay, so the number that's on top, that goes underneath, so there's 200. Again, I'm going to write it as a decimal, just in case things don't go evenly, and we'll be able to expand things out a little bit, but I think in this case it will. So again, I think, okay, the number 25, will 25 go into the number 2 a whole number of times? Well, no, 2 is too small. So then I look over one number bigger, I look at 20, and I think, well, how many times does the number 25 go into 20? Well, again, it won't go into it any times. So then I move over one more time, and I think, well, 25 goes into 200 how many times? Well, 25 will go into 200 8 times, and you basically need to put the number on the rightmost digit. So I'm thinking about the number 200, so 25 goes into 200 8 times. I put 8 above the very last digit. And then I take 8 times 25, which is simply 200. And, well, that's going to leave us with a remainder of 0. So it says 25 will go into the number 200 8 times exactly. So, to make a short story long, it says 2 divided by 0.25 is simply equal to 8. And, you know, the way I think about it, this makes sense to me. To me it says, 0.25, I always think about money, quarters. You know, how many quarters are in $2? That's, to me, kind of a conceptual way of thinking about this problem. Well, there are 8 quarters in $2. So, for me, I don't know, at least when I did decimals, not in all cases, but sometimes I like to think about it in terms of money. Somehow it gives me something a little more concrete to think about. So, okay, let's go to our next example. So 15.6, and we're going to divide that by the number 0.12. So I'm going to do the same thing as in the last one. Maybe we'll go through this one a little bit faster here. Notice the number on top, 15.6. I'm going to add in an extra 0. That's not going to change its numerical value. And again, the only reason why I'm adding in that extra 0 is I notice that in the denominator, I'm going to have to move the decimal over 2 times, just like in the last case. So 1, 2, I'll move the decimal place over 1, 2 times in the top part. So this problem is going to be equivalent to the problem of taking 1560 and dividing it by the number 12. Okay, so I'm going to make my division just like a second ago. So 1560, that goes underneath. We're dividing by 12, that goes on the outside. So I think, well, does 12 go into 1? No, it's not big enough. Will 12 go into 15? Absolutely. It will go into it one time. So then we just take 1 times 12, which is 12. Subtract the 15 and 12, that'll give us 3. And then we simply have to drop down our 6. I'm going to put my decimal place back in there before I forget. So we simply drop down our 6. And well, now I think, does 12 go into 36? Absolutely. 12 will go into 36 3 times. So then I think 3 times 12 is 36. I subtract. You have to drop down all the digits in the top part. And then I think, well, does 12 go into 0? Well, 0 times. And at this point, I think you can see that things are just going to keep repeating, because you'll get 0 times 12, which is 0, subtract, you'll get 0, and things are just going to keep going on forever and ever and ever. So what it says is, if we take the number, the original number, 15.6 divided by 0.12, that's simply going to equal the number 130, okay? So last but not least here, let's do one more. So let's take this number 0.286 and divide it by 0.4. Well, notice in this time I'm just going to have to move the decimal place once in the bottom and consequently once in the top. So really I'm going to think about this as being 2.86 divided by the number, the whole number 4. So again, my goal in these problems is I'm making the number in the denominator into a whole number. And again, I just do the same thing now. Okay, so I gotta be maybe a little careful here. So 2.86. And sometimes what some people will do is just drop their decimal place down right at the beginning. You know, wherever the decimal place is, just move it to the top. And that'll keep things, I think, help keep things lined up. Okay, so when I'm doing my division, I really am almost pretending like the decimal place isn't there at all. So I think, you know, will 4 go into 2? Well, 4 will go into 2 0 times. So 0 times 4 is 0. Let's subtract. 2 minus 0 is 2. Then I drop down the 8. Again, I don't drop the decimal with it. At this point, I'm just pretending that there are no decimals. So I think 4 times what is 28? Well, I think 4 times 7 will be 28. Again, we subtract. We would have to drop down our next number. So when we subtract, we would simply get 0. We would pull down the 6. And I'm going to keep going. I'm going to add in a couple more zeros just to make sure. So I think 4 will go into 6 how many times? Well, just one time. 1 times 4 is simply 4. If we subtract, 6 minus 4 is going to be 2. Let's drop down our next 0. And I think we're there at this point. So I think 4 times what is 20? Well, that's going to be something exact. 4 times 5 is 20. So I'm running out of room down here. But if we multiply and we subtract away our 20, we're simply going to get zeros, and 4 will go into 0 0 times. So after that, you would just start getting a bunch of zeros. And, you know, if you're not positive about all these zeros, you know, keep doing a few more steps and convince yourself that this is, in fact, what will happen. But since it does all turn into zeros, we will just simply leave those numbers off. So it says that the original number we started with, 0.286 divided by 0.4, that's going to be the same thing as the number 0.715, and that'll be our final answer in this case. So again, to me, the basic idea when doing division, just get rid of the decimals in the denominator by moving the decimal place over so many times. You have to move the decimal place the same number of times in the numerator. And then it's just keeping decimal places lined up and doing, regular old long division. So I hope this example helps, these examples help and make some sense. If you have any questions or comments, as always, feel free to post them.